Hello and welcome back to AquaTerra-Life. I'm Niels and today we are observing an exciting stage in our sword-tailed newt larvae's journey. Now about 3 months old, they've grown a lot and are starting their transition from aquatic larvae to terrestrial juveniles, a process called metamorphosis. Let's take a closer look. Over the past few weeks, the larvae have shown significant changes. Some of them have begun to reduce their gills, like this one here, which is one of the first signs they are preparing for life on land. This process, known as metamorphosis, is a complex transformation where they shift from fully aquatic larvae to semi-terrestrial juveniles, capable of both swimming and eventually moving onto land. To help them through this change, I'll add a piece of floating cork bark to this setup. This will serve as a resting place if they feel ready to leave the water temporarily. As their gills shrink, they rely more on lungs to breathe air, so providing a place for them to access land is essential. Cork bark is ideal because it's natural, safe and easy for young newts to climb onto thanks to its textured surface. A few days later, I checked back to see if any of our newts had used the cork bark, and sure enough, the first few had fully absorbed their gills and climbed up. These newts have now completed their metamorphosis. They are ready to move to a land-based habitat, where we'll continue to monitor their growth and provide the care they need for this new stage. Also, I wanted to update you on the smaller larva that had its tail bitten off. It's healing well and its tail has mostly regrown, although it's still a little smaller than the others, so I've kept it in its own box for now. Metamorphosis is a fascinating but energy-intensive process. As the newts develop, they absorb their gills and reconfigure their body structure to function in a more terrestrial environment. This transformation is a critical time for them, requiring stable conditions and close monitoring. Soon, they'll rely entirely on lungs and need a more land-focused environment to thrive. And that's all for today's video. We've seen some of our newts begin their transition, setting the stage for the next step in their development. In our next episode, we'll take a look on how to set up their first terrestrial environment as they fully leave the water behind. Thank you for watching, and as always, remember to like, subscribe and hit the notification bell to keep following the journey of these incredible newts.